Upon completing the first volume of his History of the French Revolution, Thomas Carlyle sent the manuscript to his friend, John Stuart Mill, whose domestic servant mistook it for waste paper and used it as a firelighter. Thus, Carlyle was being somewhat literal when he described the French Revolution as a book directly and flamingly from the heart. Here I'll be taking a look at the single volume edition published by the Limited Editions Club in 1956. The book is presented in a gold slipcase that is edged in blue linen and bears a title label on the spine. The binding is quarter leather with plain blue linen cloth sides, and the spine is stamped in gold. The red Morocco leather has a fairly coarse grain, but looks quite handsome alongside the blue cloth and gold text. The binding is sewn with off-white head and tail bands, while the end papers are plain white. In light of the book's subject matter, it's apt that the text is typeset in Grandjean, a Garamond face that was derived from a book printed in Paris in 1592. The overall typographical design is understated but elegant. Also fitting was the Limited Editions Club's choice of illustrator for this edition. Bernard Lamotte was born and educated in Paris and painted many charming images of that city. The illustrations here are monochrome but full of atmosphere and sense of movement, capturing the impassioned kinetic energy of revolution. Each illustration is paired with a caption that quotes from the text. They are reproduced in collotype by Arthur Jaffe. Text and illustration alike are printed on slightly off-white colophon text paper made by the Curtis Paper Company. Printing and binding took place in New York. As for the text itself, it's tough going. Carlyle's style is poetic and a little bit archaic. The author introduces important historical characters without pausing to explain who they are or what their significance to events will be. Throw in a bunch of mostly untranslated French expressions, and the result can only be confusion and bewilderment. Prudent readers will therefore go into this book having already acquired at least some knowledge of the events it describes. That said, Carlyle's epic of history does have a couple of merits. Firstly, there's something captivating in its prose, which has all the quality of an epic poem. Secondly, Carlyle has an uncanny knack for making the reader feel like they are a face peering out of the crowd, watching events unfold. There's an introduction by Cecil Brown that contrasts the French Revolution with its antecedent in America and the revolutions of the 20th century. The book closes with a chronology of the revolution, which can be helpful if you lose track of Carlyle's narrative. At the end of the book is the colophon page, which identifies this as one of 1,500 copies printed. The page is signed by the illustrator and bears a stamped edition number.